Hi guys, welcome to the second video. Hey, hi. This is my second YouTube video. I've just done the one on my eyebrows, so now I'm gonna do one on hooded eyelids. And I'm gonna try and tone it down for you guys. I'm gonna keep it natural, but also I'm gonna keep it my look, like my look. I friggin' love, absolutely love bright colors. So we're gonna see what happens. So first of all, guys, I'm gonna prime my eyes with Monistat. This is a chafing relief powder gel, but it is amazing. I swear by it, guys. Honest to God, I swear by it. It's absolutely fucking, it makes your makeup look flawless. Also, I'm gonna prime my eyes today because I never normally prime them, and they seemed to look alright last night. So we'll prime the eyes. We will prime the eyes, guys. We will prime the eyes. You have to excuse the stained lids. I did use my Morphe 35B last night and it stained the bad boys. So I do apologize, guys, for that. I have washed my face, don't worry, I'm not a scruff. Not today, anyway. So yeah. Right, let's get on with the tutorial. So we're gonna go in, guys. I'm just gonna make sure I've got a clean brush. I'm gonna prime my eyes first. Sorry, I do apologize. Oh god, I'm dropping things. Right, I'm gonna prime my eye first. I'm gonna use this little bit of a blue blender. It is dirty. I did use it last night, but we're gonna use this to pat on some product onto the top of my eyelid. Get rid of them dirty hairs. So you just wanna prime your eye. If you've got eye primer, use eye primer. I just use foundation, but definitely use eye primer if you have eye primer, like a color eye primer. I mean, I don't know what I mean, I'm not a professional. I think you can actually get, like, I think MAC Paint Pot is an eye primer. I think it's just like a really, really, any concealer basically, guys, any concealer you have. I just use foundation because I don't use concealer. Just gonna try and get rid of this pink. I know I can't sing, guys. You will hear me a lot attempting to sing. I know I can't sing, so don't think I'm doing it because I think I can. I'm not trying to show off. I'm not trying to anything like that. I'm just singing because I like singing, and it's even better because I can't sing, so I just make it sound like a twat. For you guys, it's all for you guys. It's all for you guys. Right, so guys, I'm gonna have a look at my 35 Morphe, my 35B from Morphe, see if I can find some colours in there. Right, I don't know what we're gonna use. Eye bogey, sorry guys. Let's use, I know what to use. Right, I've got a new sleep palette, guys. It's called Bad Girl, right? So let's attempt to use that. I think I need a bigger thing for my palettes. I'm just gonna find this palette, guys. Do apologize. Give me one second. Anyway, do you like my nails, guys? Do you like my nails? They are color changing gel. If you like the link for them also, just comment down below and I'll put the link in the comments. Nothing. Right, so I've got Whimsical Wonderland, we've got Acid's too bright, Whimsical Wonderland's too me. Guys, I've got 15 palettes here, so you'll have to excuse me a second. Oh, I know what to use. Oh no, that's not. Garden of Eden. This might be a nice nude colours. Yeah, let's use Garden of Eden. So these are the natural colours, but they're also, they're not browns, they're greens and browns. So yeah. Can't never open this palette. I've just opened it as well and closed it. Right, guys. So this is our Garden of Eden Sleek palette. It is absolutely stunning. The names are Garden of Eden, Eve's Kiss, Paradise on Earth, Python, Forbidden, Flora, Entwined, Adam's Apple, Pig. Oh no, Fig, sorry, not Pig, Fig. Correction. Evergreen, Fauna, and Tree of Life. So they're the colours we have, guys. And we're going to start off with a... Right, I'm going to start off with my 35B, guys, just because it's got a nudier colour. So I'm going to go in with my more 35B. And I'm just going to take out the really, really pale colour up here, look. Really, really pale colour, guys. And that is going to be my transition colour. So I'm just going to whack that all over the lid. All over the lid. I shouldn't have done this. I should have put some setting powder on, but we're halfway through now, so it don't matter. The setting powder, guys, and this as well, is just so... It's just to set the foundation that you just put down and stop the product from sitting into your creases. So it slides about. I'm assuming so anyway. It works better when you put a base down like this. Like I say, I normally use setting powder, but today, yeah, I forgot. So you will have to excuse that, guys. I didn't realise I'm being very, very quiet compared to what I normally am. It's because you aren't here to hype me up, but I am being myself still. I am not fake. Right, guys, I'm going to go in with, I'm going to start with this dark brown here. And it is called Tree of Life. No, it's not. It's Flora. So we're going to go in with Flora and we're going to just cut the crease. And we're going to use a flat brush if I can find one that's clean. Next time, guys, I promise I will organise myself better. So I'm going to take a flat brush, guys. A flat, fat brush. And I'm going to just put it where I want to put it. Basically, right, guys. If you have hooded eyes and you do your hood... If you do it to your crease there and you open your eyes, you're not going to see anything. You're not going to see a thing. So let me just explain. Let me just show you. So I'm putting this on my crease where everyone else normally puts their eyeshadow, yeah? So I'll put that on. It's gone. You can't see it. Because them hoods cover everything. So what you need to do, guys, is go a little bit above your crease. So you can still see it, look. You can still see the line. And you just wanna pat it in. I like the almond shape, guys, so I'm just gonna like come out a little bit more. And I do like a dramatic look as well, guys. A very dramatic look. If you know me, you know I like my bright colors, and this is all nude. So this to me is all like, what do we do here then? What color do we use with that? So we're just gonna put that there, guys, like that. As you see, you can still see it. You can still see it. In fact, this can practice as well because I've got a wedding trial next week, a wedding to do next weekend. So yeah, this is practice for me too, guys. I'm gonna try and do this on her. This is basically the look that she's gonna have anyway. So we're gonna try and get that a little bit rounder, guys, and a little bit more towards the shape of my eyebrow. Alright, so that's that one done. Like I say, guys, I am not a professional. Hey, hey, hi, hi to new viewers. I appreciate your time. I appreciate you sitting here and watching this. Thank you so, so much, guys. And if you're a hater, thank you, you too. Thank you to you too, because you have took the views up, guys. So thank you. No love lost for the haters. It's all love, love, love. So, we're going to get them to a point where they're all right-ish. And we've kind of got the shape of what we want. So we're just going to darken these corners up here, guys. And then what you're going to do is you're going to take a clean, fluffy brush. Like this one I have here that I've just used for the base. Just going to whippy, whappy, whappy, whippy. And then you're just going to... We might be here for a while blending this, guys, but it's all about the blend. It's all about your blend, guys. As long as this blend is perfect, it doesn't matter about anything else. Get the blend right and you've got everything else right, guys. I promise. One more time. So I'm just blending, guys. I am going to add a bit more, don't worry. So this is the dark brown in the Sleek palette. And I'm just blending to get the... this is basically the transition colour, but it's not at the same time. It's the base colour, put it that way. So we're going to add more colour to it. We're going to add more to it. Because this is going to be like, it's going to be a natural look, but it's going to be a dark natural look. Because like I say, guys, I am not a natural person, but I'm going to try my best to make it as natural as possible so you guys can copy. This works with any colours, guys. The look that I'm doing will work with any colours. As long as they match, obviously. Well, they cannot match, they can match, it's up to you. Personally, I just go in with anything that comes to hand. So this is the dark brown still, guys. And I'm just darkening these creases up, these edges up. Because that's where we want the darkness to be. We want them to be on the edge and lightened up in the middle. Because this is going to be a natural cut crease. So guys, that is our brown down. Next, we're going to go in with a green. Are we? Right, let's go in with this green here, guys. Just like in the corners, in the creases. Let's get this brush again. So I've got a bit of that dark green, and the dark green is called Tree of Life. And we're just going to put it a little bit further down than what we put the last lot. I know it looks messy at the minute, guys, but just trust the process. So we're going to stick that there, and then we're going to stick a little bit on this side too. One more time. So we're just going to put as much product as we can without ruining it, guys. A little bit higher this side. Right. That's as much as I probably want to go. So now I'm going to go back in with this brush, guys. I'm just going to wipe it off. Gonna go with a clean brush, guys. So this is a clean fluffy brush, and we're gonna blend again, circular motions again, guys. So blend that green out so it's nice and blended with the brown, and make sure you blend it inwards as well, because we don't just want it to be like in a line. One more time. Right, so that's that one, guys. I'm just going to blend this one in as well. Sorry, guys, my eyes are really buggy. So I find if I do this on this eye, it goes on a little bit better. Right, so guys, that's our natural smoky look for now. I've got more to add. We're going to do a cut crease as well. So I'm just going to get a little bit of that green and just go back in. And just blend it out that little bit better up there. A little bit more this side. So guys, as you can see, my eyes are open and you can still see the eyeshadow. Yes? Great. So next we're gonna go in with a cut crease. The cut crease is, and that was another thing you need to learn, guys. So we're gonna go in with a cut crease, and we're gonna do it with, just give me 1 second. So we're gonna use our little brush again. I'm gonna go back in with the Superstay 24, and we're going to do a cut crease, guys, and I will show you what I want you to do with this cut crease. I'm going to use a different brush just because it's a little bit better. So I'm going to use like a flatter, longer brush, so just so I can like pull it a bit more, whereas that brush, you can't really do much with it. So a tip for hooded eyes and cut creases. So you want to put a dab there, yeah? Roll your eyes at the haters, guys. And there's your top of your cut crease. You just want to go a little bit above that. So I'm going to say about there, yeah? So we'll go down. And then we'll start from the inner corner. And we'll draw up towards the top. And then just fill it in. Don't forget, guys, you have hooded eyes, so you cannot do a normal cut crease. This is the best that you can go. You have to go a bit more up than what you normally would. So there's your cut crease, guys. There's a cut crease cut. So we're going to do the other side now. Again, a blob on the top here. And then you roll your eyes. Roll your eyes at the haters. Let me just get a little bit more on here. So we've got that bit there. I'm going to go a little bit above that. There. Bring it down. There you go. Don't worry if you don't get it the first time, guys, because it's took me long enough to learn how to do it, and I'm still learning now, guys. I'm still learning new tricks and new tips and new ways to do makeup. I do my own nails too, and I'm still learning with that. I've been doing it for 4 years. I'm still learning. You can always do better than your last. Just remember that, girls. Never ever bring yourself down. Just remember, you can do it. If I can do it, you can do it. Be yourself. Be yourself. Don't let anybody bring you down. Don't let anybody tell you anything different. Honest to God, girls. The best thing I did was come live to you lot on Facebook. Starting on Facebook. The best thing I did was come live to you lot. And you lot big me up so much to the point where I thought, I can do this. I can do this for these guys. And these guys are helping me so friggin' much. It's unreal. Right, guys, I'm going to go in with a little bit of shimmer now. So I'm going to get a little sponge tip applicator, if I can find one anywhere. So I'm going to get my sponge tip applicator. And because we are using green, there is a bit of green on it already, so we're going to use that. I'm going to use... I'm going to put gold here. And then I'm going to blend it out to like the darker green shimmer. So let's put not the gold, it's like a brown, like a browny gold. So it's this colour here. And it is the colour Gates of Eden up here. That's the colour I'm using, guys. So I'm going to go in there. Look, as you can see, I've got a hooded eye, so now I've got a line. Just dab that away there quick before you do your makeup, because that line will show. If you just go straight on with shimmer, that line will show. Trust me, guys. Right, so this one. You dab it on. But little boys, that's not a stab at Michael. That's just a metaphor. I'm just psycho. I go a little bit crazy sometimes. Sorry, guys. I love this song. So just going to get that in there, guys. And then we're gonna go the other side. Again, get rid of that line, because it will stay there. And dab, dab, dab. All right, now lose it. Just lose it. I hope this looks natural enough for you guys. Because you guys know me, and this is very subtle for me. It might not be for you guys, but we all know it is for me. So now I put that in, I'm going to put a little bit of lime green in there, because I like the green. Sorry, guys. So I'm going to go in with, this one's called, which one should we go for? Right, so let's go for fig. So we're going to go for fig, which is this bright lime green. I'm going to take the sponge tip applicator again. and we're gonna dab. We're gonna dab it in there a lot. Oh, look at that. Oh, look at that bitch. Oh, look at that bitch. Oh, yeah, bitch. Oh, yeah. Yeah. I like it. I like it a lot, girls. Don't forget, girls, if I can do it, you can do it too. Don't let anybody ever tell you any different. Like it is, I promise you. It takes practice. I'm not going to say it don't. And you will get disheartened sometimes because it won't go your way. Or you'll get your eyeliner where you didn't want it. Or you have to start again because it's just not how you like it. But that's fine. That's learning. And that's learning. That's just learning. So don't let anyone ever tell you you can't do it. Don't ever think you can't do it because you can. I promise you, girls, you can. Please, please believe me. Right, I'm going to go in now, guys, with the darker green shimmer. Which is this one here. And it is called Fauna. So we're going to get that dark green shimmer, guys. I'm going to stick it here on the end of the cut crease. But then when that's in, we're going to go back in with the darker green. And we're going to blend it all together, guys. Don't worry. Don't worry if it just looks like a couple of lines on your face for now, because we will blend that together. So that's our cut crease in, guys. Yeah. So now we're going to make the shadows friends instead of relatives instead of friends. So we're going to blend them all together, girls. We're going to blend them all together. Right, so we're going to get the brown and we're going to get the lime green that we've just done. I'm going to go in like this. Look, we're going to go in. Oh. Right, that's me coming out again. Calm the fuck down, girl. Right, this side. So they're intertwined now. They are one. Yeah? So they're one. So now we want to go in with the darker green and the lighter green and try and get these two to blend together. So again, guys, look at the blend. All it is just a little bit of a tug. To blend them together. If you're not confident with using full colours yet, you can use one colour on this. This is one colour. I'm just extravagant and I like to be different and I like to be out there. So this is why. This is the only reason why mine looks like this now, guys. But if you're not if you don't feel confident enough yet, that's fine. That's absolutely fine. You do the colours that you want to do, girls. So I'm going to use this same brush that I've just used. And I'm going to take the green and I'm going to go around the cut crease. Just so it's that little bit more defined, guys. You don't have to do this. You don't have to do this at all. So now I'm going to go in again with the brush that I used a minute ago. And I'm going to get the dark green. And we're going to blend here. I'm going to attempt to get these two colours matching. Circular motions, guys, if you can. That's pretty much done, guys. I'll do you a quick wing to show you how to do a wing on hooded eyes. Let me just go back in with a lighter colour. So this is why we use the transition colour, guys. So that transition colour that we used, I'm now going to go back in with it and try and blend it out so it don't look as harsh on the lines. As you can see, my eyes are open and you can still see everything. So I'm going to go back in with this transition colour, guys, and just try and blend it here to the best of my ability. So just blending that out, guys, the best we can. You don't have to do this if you did the blending first the right time, so don't worry. I'm just a messy shite and I get it everywhere. Just gonna go back in again with this one. Right, so now guys, I'm gonna go in with an eyeliner. I'm gonna use my I'm not gonna use anything, I can't find it. God, do it next time, guys. I promise you, I will have everything set up in front of me. See you, look. So I'm gonna use my liquid eyeliner, and it is Master Ink by Maybelline New York. This, guys, I don't really advise it because it does make your face sting for some fucking strange reason. It makes your eyes sting, I'm not gonna lie. I'm just gonna show you how to do a wing with it with hooded eyes. So, open your eyes, look at where your crease ends here. So you want to drag it out instead of up. Drag it out. And then where you'd normally start here and go out to your wing. It's weird, right, so instead of going here and up, you start here and drag it in, but don't go past your line. This line you have here, don't drag it up into that, because if you do that, that's when you get transition. It's not transition, is it? You get that fucking thing. I know what I mean. Anyway, you get that line that you don't want. So you start here. And you make a really, really, really thin line. If you want to make it longer, you can make it longer. That's what I'm going to do now. So you make it longer. And then you start in the middle and pull it back. So guys, I know that the wing looks weird, but unfortunately that's how you have to wear them if you want a wing that's not gonna transition to other colours. What's the fucking word? Transfer. See, this is stinging, this is. So we need to do wings like this so they don't transfer up to your eye. So there's the hooded eye look. Eyebrows, guys, that's in my last video. If you want to watch the tutorial on the eyebrows, that's my last video, obviously. Again, we'll try it again. Probably not the same. But bring it out. And bring it in, not past your line. Remember, do it like this, guys, because if you do it like that, your line disappears, look, you can't see it. So keep your eyes open so you can see what you're doing. I'm not gonna lie, guys, this is probably the best wings I've done in a while. I'll say that now and I mess up. Oh my god. I don't want to fall into bad habits, old habits, and lift my eye. So I'm going to just. Bring that up to there a little bit. Right, so like I say, guys, unfortunately, because of the shape of our eyes, we cannot have full wings. And this is the best you can probably do. We could probably get away with a little bit of a long wing. But this, guys, is it for me. This is what I want to look like. This is how I feel comfortable. I get no trans... I can't remember that fucking word again. I keep burping, I do apologize again. Right, I'm going to go in with the W7 Lashtastic False Lash Liquid Lashes. And then I'm going to show you how to put mascara, eyelashes on. So, start from your root and wiggle it. And it gets it all in the root. And that's where you want it. That's what lifts it up, the root. So just get it where you want to get it. Again, use mascara before you put lashes on because it's got something to stick to. Whereas eyelashes are really soft. So just try and get as much on as you can without taking the piss. Because we're not focusing on the eyes, on the eyelashes, sorry. It's about the eyelashes we're going to put on.
Good morning out there in Radio Land. Today we have a very special guest live in our studio, here to perform her new hit single, Walk Away, Kelly Clarkson.
I thought there's a guy that sang this, I'm not even going to lie. Right. So the lashes I use, guys, I fucking highly recommend these lashes every single time. I've got that many packets of them. They're just ridiculous now. Like, so many packets. Like, oh my fucking god. Like, oh my god. And there's still more in the in here. Anyway, we're going to use today. Let's see if we can use some that I've already opened. Yes, let's use you. I'm going to use these fucking bad boys, guys. Excuse the glue on here. Excuse that. I'm aware I'm a very scruffy tramp, so I do apologise for that. So anyway, you're going to pull the lashes off and you're going to cut them to your shape, your size. I have, I just take the ends off normally, like a little bit each side. This one's got a bit of a longer thing on it, so we're just going to take that off. And then I'll take, if you look, the first lash off. That's how I do it, the first lash off. And then we get our duo glue. I use duo glue. If you would like the link for this, I will put everything I've used today in the description box below. So you can all purchase it yourself if you want to. I'll put everything in the description box below. So again, get your lashes in the middle. Take anything you want, really. I'll just take the end of my brush because it's just a lot easier. So I'll take the end of my brush and I just scoop on the duo glue. I do realise there's going to be people watching this that's never seen me before and they're going to be like, who the fuck are you? What are you even doing on fucking YouTube? Bitch, I'm on YouTube because you asked me to come on YouTube. Gosh, right. I'm blowing them, guys, because you don't want to put them on wet. If you put them on wet, they will just slide off your eyelash. They won't stick where they want, where you want it to stick. And they'll just be, yeah, they'll just be all over the place. So make sure your glue is sticky before you put it on. Or tack it, either one. Whichever word you want to use. So now, you stick it. I'm doing this really far away from the mirror, guys. I'm doing it for you. So you stick it in the middle of your eyelid, eyelid, whichever. And then pull each corner down into place. And there you have a perfectly applied eyelash, guys. And if I don't say so myself, some fucking bubble eyelashes too. So there's one eyelash, guys. It looks a little bit too long, but we can deal with that. So now I'm going to take the other one off, guys. And again, I'm just going to show you what I'm going to do. So I'm going to take the end off here. There's like a little tiny, tiny, tiny end. So we're just going to take that little tiny end off. And then we're going to take this first eyelash off. Oh, shit. This first eyelash off here. And then again, guys, take your tweezers that you put down and you don't know where the fuck you're going. Are we serious? They're right in front of you, you fucking idiot. Right, anyway. Again, grab the eyelash in the middle. Grab your gloopy gloopy duo duo gluo. And I will put the link for everything I've used today, guys, in the description box below. So I've used the Garden of Eden Sleek palette. I will get the link for that, guys. I have used my Vivis collection eyelashes, and I'll get you the link for that. It's buy two, get one free as well, guys. So please, please, please buy, because they are fucking amazing. I don't get any credit for anything I try and sell to people, basically. I'm just giving you what I think's amazing. So don't think that I'm getting paid for this, guys, because I'm not getting paid for anything. And the guys that know me on Facebook, I'm here because I love doing makeup and I love empowering women. Anybody really. Excuse me. Anybody really. If you want to fucking do it, then fucking do it, girls. Don't let anybody tell you any different, right? So get this in your middle. In the middle again. Corner. Down. And then this corner. I think that's down. No, it's not. And that's down. So, see, guys, it's so fucking easy. And then I just go around with my tweezers after and just flatten into my lashes. Only because my nails are too long to do that. So, wait for this one to glue. Wait for this one to dry a little bit, and then I'll do the same to this one. Guys, I really, really hope that this eye makeup has helped you. I will continue to do the rest of my face, but I don't think that's what you want to see. So I'm just going to skip the foundation stage and just do the under eye stage, and then just show you what you could possibly do under eyes. You don't need to do under eyes. If you've got hooded eyes, they tell you not to do the under eyes. Can't remember why, because it takes, I don't fucking know. Right, anyway, so guys, I'm just going to go in with that green again, and we're going to go underneath. So you don't need loads, guys, you just need to dab. You don't need loads, you just need that little tiny bit of colour so you can just see underneath. Again, this side. Oh, I know what I might do. I might go live on Facebook and do the rest of my face. Ooh, might do that. Yeah, because then I can show off this video as well. Yeah. Let's do that, guys. Thank you if you've just come over from my Facebook Live too. Because what I'm going to do is I'm going to edit these and I'm going to get them uploaded onto YouTube so you guys can see them. And then, yeah. So we'll get them underneath, guys. And then we're just going to go in with that gold again and just do the inner corner. So there we go, guys. Oh my God, it's in my fucking eyeball. There we go, guys. We've used the Garden of Eden Sleek palette, Vivis collection eyelashes. I'll put all the links below. What I'm gonna do first, so I might just go live on Facebook first and then I'll do all that afterwards so you can all come and watch. I'm just gonna put a little bit of mascara on the bottom lashes. Not loads, guys, just a little bit, just to give it, just so they know, you know, they're there, basically. So, yeah. Right, guys, I hope this live has helped you. I really do. This YouTube video. I'm doing this all for you guys. You asking for it, so I'm doing it. I hope that you all watch. I hope that I get viewers. I hope that I get subscribers. If not, I'm not going to do it again. Let's put it that way. Yeah, but thank you guys. Thank you guys for taking the time out of your day to watch me. And yeah, I love you all lots. Empower them bitches, yeah? Just be good. Just be yourself. Just be you. Just help other people be themselves. Just be yourself, girls, and that's all that matters, really. That's what I'm about. So yeah, if you catch me rambling on like I am doing, it's because normally I've got things to read in front of me, but today I haven't. So yeah, love you all, leave you all. Thank you all again. Please share, please like, please subscribe. Love you all, leave you all. Bye.